I can't believe I'm saying this, but today is my last day on 75 Hard. Today is June 18th, and that marks exactly 75 days since I started, so I still have to complete today. But I wanted to start with weighing myself. We'll see what I'm down to. I weighed myself last week and I was exactly 20 pounds lighter. So we'll see if anything has changed in the last week. I feel a little bit tighter, but we'll see. You never know. So we're gonna start out with that just to get that over with, and we'll see how this goes. I'm 138. Guys, I have not seen a 3 since I think, I don't know, maybe after my twins. That's crazy. I might have gotten down to the 30s, but I've really mostly maintained in the 40s for the majority of my life after having kids. So I guess that's what working out twice a day and not having any cheat meals will do over a 75 day period.
To be honest, I didn't plan on anybody but myself ever seeing this before video. So it's not filmed well, I just filmed it on my phone, but I really did it more so that I could see where I was measuring myself so I could get accurate measurements when I did my after. But since I had this video, I thought I could share it with you to show the difference in how quickly a body can really change just by diet and exercise. It's crazy. I did end up losing a total of 15 and a half inches in 75 days. So I'm super pleased with that. I'm really happy about those results. But for the majority of the rest of this video, I will be sharing my tips and my advice on doing 75 hard if this is something that you're interested in. I would suggest having it pre-planned, like don't just jump in it tomorrow. Really get mentally prepared for this challenge. I did a week before I knew, okay, in 1 week I'm going to start this challenge. I think setting yourself up for success and planning ahead of how you're going to kind of execute with this whole 75 hard program, figure out what your goals are, what your plans are, and just kind of go from there. For the rest of this video, I wanted to just share my tips, my advice, maybe some Q&A a little bit. I do have some more questions that I can answer in this video, and just kind of my experience on 75 hard and what I feel like it's done for me, and my advice to anyone who's contemplating starting this journey. So for those of you who are watching this and don't know anything about 75 hard, 75 Hard is a mental toughness challenge that Andy Frasilla created. He is the owner of First Form. So if you have no idea what 75 Hard is and you're thinking about doing it, I would first go and listen to his podcast. So just Google Andy Frasilla, First Form, 75 Hard, you'll find his podcast. He does swear a lot in the podcast, so if you're not into that, maybe then I don't know what to tell you, but I'll give you some detail. But I feel like his podcast explains the why behind it, why these are the things on the checklist. So anyway, that's what I would suggest doing before you actually start your 75 hard journey. Here is my checklist. So I got this off of Etsy. I will have it linked below for anyone interested. I get asked all the time, where'd you get your checklist? So you can, there is an app, like a 75 hard app that you can download on your phone. I like the physical checklist that I like watch myself check things off every day. So I will go through what is on this checklist. So every day, you follow a specific diet. Here's the thing, I get a lot of questions about this too, like, well, what diet, I don't know what I can eat on this. The thing is, you choose your diet. So you get to choose. Some people do keto, Some people do no sugar, they're not gonna have any sugar. I did macros, so that's way more flexible. I knew that I could stick to it if I did macros, and that's why I chose macros. If you've never done keto and you decide I'm gonna do 75 hard and I'm gonna do keto on 75 hard, that will be so hard. Like you probably, I'm just gonna say, you probably won't stick through it if you're doing something you've never tried before. I would suggest picking a diet you know that you could stick to for 75 days, because the thing is you cannot have a single cheat meal. So with macros, because it is kind of anything goes on macros, I decided to choose, I wasn't gonna eat fast food and I wasn't going to have candy. So anything else could go in my macros. I could have, I mean, every day I had some kind of shake, like a protein shake that tasted like a malt, like an ice cream brownie batter or cake batter malt. I made one of those for me every day. So I never felt like I was really, someone just delivered a package and it opened my door. Okay, anyway, I never really felt like I was really restricted on this meal plan, because I could, you know, if I could eat what I was craving that day. I just said no to fast food and to candy. But again, you get to choose what your diet is. No alcohol or cheat meal, so that's actually the second check mark, okay? So you can't have any alcohol and no cheat meals at all. The third thing is you have to work out 2 times a day. And they have to be for 45 minutes. Again, you get to choose what your workouts are. I never stepped foot in the gym, not a single time. I did the Whitney Simmons workout from home. It's called Alive, and I will show you what that looks like right here. But I did her workout at least once a day. Sometimes I did them twice a day. And so I just kind of picked like, okay, well, my legs are sore, so I'm not gonna do legs today. I'll just do an upper body, or I'll do something else. Kind of towards the end here, I did a lot of walks for my second workout, and I did a lot of like yoga, stretching types of things. You don't have to do like high intensity things. Again, you get to decide what the workouts are. I did want to see results quick, so I tried to do some kind of like high intensity workout or a weightlifting workout every day. At least one of them was like that every day. And then, but the other thing is one of your workouts has to be outside. So when I started this, it was in April. I started the day after Easter and it snowed quite a few times and I had to work out outside in the snow. And if you're wondering, well, why, if it's raining or snowing, I should just work out inside. In his podcast, he explains why one of them is outside. That's kind of the point, is you want it to be uncomfortable. So like right now, it is so hot here now that when I work out outside, it's torture. So either way, I'm like, it was either snowing or it's like 100 degrees outside. Either way, it was uncomfortable, but that's kind of the point of one of the workouts being outside. The other one, which became the hardest thing for me here at the end, is you have to drink 1 gallon of water every day. When it comes to tips for drinking your gallon of water every day, I would suggest having some kind of larger jug so you're not drinking like 100 water bottles. This way, you know exactly how many times you need to fill this up. For this specific one, I needed to fill it up 3.5 times. I would keep track of how many times I'd filled it up, and I try to have like 1.5 to 2 of them done by noon, because there is a side effect to drinking this much water. And with how much I hate public bathrooms, I tried my hardest to get water in while I was home and not having to like run in public bathrooms everywhere I went, but I still found myself having to do that basically every time that I was out. Another one is you have to take a progress picture every single day. That's kind of an easy one. That was always the first thing I did. I woke up, took my progress picture, so I felt like, okay, I'm starting to check off my stuff right away. And then the last thing is you have to read 10 pages of a book. It has to be a nonfiction book, and it cannot be an Audible. It can't be something you listen to. It has to be a physical book that you read. That is what 75 hard is in a nutshell. Now I will kind of go on and share some of my tips and what I did. One of my first tips is you have to take this day by day. I feel like because you have this checklist of things you have to cross off every day, it helps you stay like on task for the day and not looking ahead. It's like, what do I need to do right now? When I looked ahead at all, those were the only times I ever felt like I'm not gonna be able to do this. Like I have this much more I have to do. So it's focusing on what you need to do right then, that day. Just look at those tasks you have to do that day and don't be focused on so much what you gotta do in the future or how much longer you have. Because now looking back, when I look back to the first day, I'm like, man, that kind of felt like it was a long time ago. But also I'm like, it's literally not even 11 weeks. So really think, you guys, it's like 2.5 months. You can do that for 2.5 months. I don't wanna say it's easy, it's called 75 hard for a reason, but when you think of the time frame and what kind of results you could get in that amount of time, it's crazy. One of the tips I also wanted to share was about your diet, and I kind of already shared this a little bit, but pick something you know you can stick to. And so when I decided I'm gonna stick to macros, I'm gonna have X amount of calories every day, X amount of protein, fat and carbs, like I'm gonna stay around that budget that I have for myself. Because it was so flexible, that's why I feel like I was able to stick to it. For once in my life, I stuck to something and it didn't feel like it was a diet because I didn't cut anything out besides like not eating candy and I'm not eating fast food. But other than that, it was like everything was left on the table. I could have whatever I wanted or whatever I was craving. For example, every Friday night, we have a pizza party. We've done this for years. Our kids always know on Friday night, we have pizza. And for me, I would have my little Lean Cuisine pizza. I didn't feel like I was being restricted at all. I was still getting pizza, but it was more calorie friendly, so I was able to enjoy it. So that's just one example of picking something that you know you could stick to, that you know you'd enjoy. And again, for me, I don't think I could have if I was cutting out an entire food group. When it comes to your workouts, I would say really listen to your body, because at the very beginning, I was trying to do like high intensity workouts twice a day. And I went from being super lazy, not really working out at all, to like hitting it twice a day really, really hard. I did have an issue with my ankle, like it swelled up to like twice the size. And I'm like, what am I even going to be able to do now? I was so worried that I was going to give up because of my injured ankle. But I just started doing things, okay, I'm gonna sit down and do weights, you know, anything that I could do that was avoiding me jumping around or using my legs at all. I had to do that for at least a week for my ankle to heal. So really listen to your body. If you're like, I cannot work out today. I can't, like I feel like I'm going to die. There was a few days I felt like that. So I did 2 yoga workouts and it was mostly just stretching. The whole purpose here of doing this every day is to get into those habits and to show yourself that you can do it no matter what. Like no matter what obstacle is in your way, even though you feel like you're actually going to die, every muscle is sore, do it anyway. Like I said, it could be some kind of stretching workouts, just getting yourself outside to one of the workouts, and you could do the other one inside, it doesn't matter. But fulfilling those tasks, even though you don't want to, you don't feel like it, but doing it anyway. Another thing I would suggest is try to get as much of your checklist done. I always try to do like half of it before noon. I just had to switch my memory card, so if the camera just changed, that's why. I tried to get half my checklist done before noon, so I would try to drink half my gallon of water by noon, get one workout in, take my progress picture, and read my book. That was what my goal was every single day, was to try to do that before noon. If you work or you have some crazy kind of schedule, obviously work around that. If you do work, I would try to get one of the workouts in before you go to work. It might be possible, but when you get home from work, work out and then work out again, that might be a little difficult. So I would try to separate those as much as possible. Get one workout early in the morning and then work out again. You could even use your lunch break for one of your workouts. You could go on a walk outside. Really, it's just up to you and your schedule, but that's what I would suggest. I felt like it made my day easier when I saw those things get checked off as early as possible. Then I felt like I could breathe a little bit for the rest of the day. And then I knew, okay, later I'm gonna get my second workout in. And sometimes I didn't even know what I was going to do. None of my days look the same. Like there was no 2 days that were identical. It was really, every day was different. I have 4 kids. I technically work from home. I do a lot of random things. I have my husband and he technically works full time. So it's like working around all of those schedules is difficult, but I feel like that's part of what's really rewarding is even though you have all of these excuses, you still did it anyway. I've had this question a lot, like what is your goal from here? Are you gonna keep going? So my goal is honestly just like kind of maintaining what I've done. I never had a goal to like get a 6-pack. I feel like I left that goal behind me in my 20s and now I just like, that's not something that I'm focused on. I just wanted to lose the rest of my baby weight. Like that was what I was hoping would come out of this. And I definitely was able to accomplish that. So really just maintaining. And now that I've learned a lot about macros, I feel like I have those down really well because of doing it very consistently over the last 75 days. For the most part, I don't really even need to log it in my phone anymore. I've been using the Lose It app. I'll show you what that looks like right here. So I would track all of my calories and everything in here, and it would keep track and tell me how much more I had left in the day. But because I've been doing it for so long, I feel like now, for the most part, I don't need to be logging it in, because I know exactly this is 333 calories and this is 193. Like, I know what I can eat every day and maintain. The good thing about that is I actually can up my calories quite a bit. I've been in the deficit this entire time, so I can up it, like, actually it might be 400 calories that I can increase, and I would be able to maintain what I have lost. The other thing, I'm going to allow myself to have cheat meals very often. I'm not restricting myself like I was. I have heard some negative things about 75 hard because people are like, it's not healthy to be so restrictive, and I see that long term. I don't believe that it is, but I definitely think that it's worth it, and I don't see anything wrong with restricting yourself for a period of time. Again, I'm not saying that for long term, but I feel like that showed me that I can restrict myself, because I felt like when I started this that I kind of felt like I was out of control and like not in control of my eating habits. And so to be able to do that for that amount of time just proved to myself that if I need to I can. And so I'm happy about that. I won't be doing crazy restrictive things anymore, but again, as long as I'm staying within my macros, then I will be able to maintain the weight that I am. So I thought that this was really crazy, but when I started 75 hard, I put in that I wanted to lose about 2 pounds a week. I think that was like the max that it would limit you to. So I was like, well, let's see what my calories would be if that was my goal. 2 pounds of fat a week, that's what I wanna lose. And it said by the time 75 hard would be done, that I would lose 22 pounds. So I was like, okay, that would put me around 138, 139. And you guys, that's exactly what I weighed. So I just wanna tell you, if you are doing macros, if you're counting macros and you're doing 75 hard, or you're just counting macros in general and you're in a deficit, whatever it says you're going to lose, if you actually stick to those macros, you will lose that amount of weight. I couldn't believe when I stepped on the scale that last day, I'm like, that's exactly what it said I would weigh at the end of this. So if you don't know anything about calculating macros, there is a free calculator online. It's called, I think you just Google, macro calculator. You type in your height, your weight, your goals. If you're male or female, there's a few things that you'll fill in. Then it will calculate your macros for you. And you can also select, once it does that, you can select if you want to have like low carb, if you want it to just be balanced. I just put balanced. I ate a ton of carbs this entire 75 hard journey. So again, I didn't feel like I was lacking in anything. In fact, there were some days I'm like, I can't possibly eat more. That's how I felt. I felt very satisfied with my diet. So I know that I'll be able to continue this long term. I didn't think I mentioned this yet, but today is not Friday anymore. So it's been a few days now since I finished. Over the weekend, I made cookies for our family, and I was just like eating cookie dough, okay? I'm like, I have waited so long to eat these cookies. They're my favorite cookies that I make, and I wanted to throw up. Like, I was like, there's no way I can go back to eating the way that I ate, because this used to not faze me at all. Like, if I just picked a cookie dough and ate cookies and whatever, I just felt so sick. But this whole weekend, I didn't even think about macros. I let myself eat whatever I wanted. And then today I'm back on, okay, let's focus on having nutritional meals and occasional treats, you know? So that's kind of where I'm at right now and what I'm planning to continue doing. Obviously, I wanna keep working out. I love the way that makes me feel too. I love that I got in the habit of working out every single day. So I wanna continue that. I probably won't work out every day, but probably closer to 5 days a week. No more 14 times a week. They do have a phase one, and I think even a phase two of 75 hard. And I know I'll get questions on that, but right now I'm not interested in doing more 75 hard. I'm not gonna say I won't in the future, because you never know. But as of now, I'm very happy to be done. I do feel weird, like not having something to check off. Like, this has just been what I do every day. All my little checklists, you know, I'm like, I kind of feel lost. I don't know what I'm doing anymore, but I think the purpose is to help create these habits that you can continue on in your life. So that's where I'm at. That's my goal for the future. My last tip for you is to tell people that you are doing the challenge, because the very first day I went on Instagram and I shared like, hey, this is what I'm doing 75 hard. And I was so naive. You know, after I had completed the day, I wasn't sore. I still felt really good and energized. I felt great. And so I went on Instagram and I told everybody what I was doing. Well, the next morning, what I didn't share was how sore I was. And I was like, what did I do? Why did I tell people I was doing this challenge? So because I did that, I felt like I was being held accountable by everybody. And I think that is the only reason that I stuck with it, is because I'm like, everybody's expecting me to complete this. Like, it's day two and I swear to you, if I did not tell you guys that I was doing it on that first day, I would have quit on day two because of how sore I was. I worked out so hard on that first day. I can't even believe I was able to continue. Like, I think back, I think that was the hardest day, was day two, with how sore that I was from the previous day's workout. So that's another suggestion. Tell people, have accountability partners, have other people do this challenge with you. Get in like group texts. That can be super beneficial for people that need that extra boost and motivation. I think that's all that I had for you in this video, but thank you guys so much for watching. And for those of you who have kind of followed along my journey over on Instagram, I know I shared a little bit more on my stories than I did here on YouTube. I've only uploaded one video about 75 Hard. So thanks again for watching, you guys, and we'll see you in the next video.